So, The first time that I was Thank you. registered voters in the city of Colombo. That's 109,000 And of course, we have to make up for about 433,000. So not enough, but it will happen, push them a little further if those votes push through. However, again, take a look at the results. You can do this at home as well on the computer, because all you have to do is hover over the icons of the senators, and you can take a look at the breakdown of the votes that they have received per region. And if you take a look, Senator Gordon has only won four regions in the Philippines, and with the other voters, region NCR, he took that as well, with 1.7 million versus 1.5 million.
Josh, Senator, can you show us the party list?
Sure, let's take a look at the party list. There are 58 congressional seats up for grabs, and there are just slightly over 120 different candidates groups divided for those 58 spots. So you need to be able to earn a seat, and you need your group needs to secure 2%, at least 2% of the total vote cost. Let's take a look at the moment. Since we've been monitoring this morning, nothing has changed as well. Only 6 groups have secured that important, all important 2%. They are the full ride, state teacher, Baltimore, one chair, Byron, and the And again, if you would like to find out more information about these different groups, you can just cover over the circles and you can find out a breakdown of the vote as well as the nominees for each group.
Just to enjoy that, the speakers have been able to tell us about this condition, the last year of the people. Let's now go to ARMM, and we're going to look at the law that has been lacking in elections. Angela, what's going on there?
Yes, Kyle. Things are finally picking up over here in Maguindanao, and 24 out of 26 municipalities have already transmitted their election results. And based on that, it's 67% of votes already counted. Incumbent Maguindanao got that leads over Salinas Quetta, so then to that mayor, Tucumas Quetta, by over 100,000 votes. As of 6 p.m., Totomo Quetta received 138,014 votes compared to Masura's 21,433 votes. And based on that, you can already see the trend of what is going to happen later on. But there are still 12 more municipalities to go, and we'll have to see how it goes. Okay, earlier today,
Thank you.
because so far refused to release any of the voters turnout at the moment. Based on the patients that we visited during the election day, voter turnout was about a range about 40 to 50%. And that is definitely lower than what might be as expected.
It's going to be interesting to see as this is the first election session that okay, Angela, before we're going to be coming back to you, let's discuss this. So, Angela, thank you for that. Let's move on to Comelec with Paterno Esmaquel, who is here in Washington. We just had a press conference with Chairman Brillantes. Paterno, what did you want to say?
Chairman Brillantes says that the Central Paper Arts group is now suspended. The Comelec of the National Board of Cancer Group is preventing the hands of people from material positions. The Comelec will continue the hands of people for the position. Once the hands of people for the material positions is finished, the SUS answer is the announcement. Chairman Brillantes made a controversial statement. He said he will make a formal announcement against his critics when everything is finished.
Over the past 7 months, the government's government, but the one that has
even though apparently Washington was a spy. The denial, however, is that he was a member of the Navy and was luckily rescued over the borders by the police, and taken here. About 60 officers in the provincial public safety company have been stationed here in Patrick at 9 a.m. this morning, determining how to power firearms and were ordered to guard the municipal hall since results here have yet to be transmitted. Police senior inspector Jacob Brown also told me they are here to make sure public sensory applications are removed, and they said they will remain here until the results have been transmitted to the provincial capital, although he said there is generally peaceful here. So that's what's happening here in Asa. So far, though, the supporters are staying out because of the rain, and things are slowing down.
In the process of this emotional victim that was killed, in the process of citizenship, the less uncertainty, the less violence, what's the mood of the voters now that they're watching and waiting for what's going to happen next?
I think it was probably a lot harder earlier today. You know, but as the days wrapped on, they realized that the CS part wasn't coming in anytime soon. They got a little bit, you know, they got calmer. Obviously, they're looking at all things calmed them down. So right now, it looks like voters are just calm. They're deciding they want to go home. Some of them will probably stay here until the official proclamation is announced. But for now, it does feel like everyone is a lot calmer, a lot more relaxed. And again, you know, it's still a tight race. So I think that's also part of why there's some tension here. There is a possibility of very small possibility that Vince allows to take the mayor of seat. But for now, supporters are feeling confident that Mayor Aralaga will be coming back to Santa. Just with what you were saying about, you know, the sooner they can proclaim the last session, that's right. For instance, the only proclamations you actually got so far in here, Cavite, was in Emos City. They were one of the first cities to transmit the results. And earlier today, Emos Mayor Makati was proclaimed over former Sakilaya. Now, if you remember, there's been a lot of tension between these two in the 2020 election. The Supreme Court, just a few weeks before the poll, ruled holder Sakilaya as the rightful mayor, although he has been the one sitting here, sitting in Emos these past 3 years. You know, they asked him to speak to the state. So the proclamation earlier today, Malisi called that his vindication. And aside from that, also, LP's third district representative, Alex Azimutula, was also proclaimed here in Emos, but those are the only ones we have so far. So the Emos elections, we also have an article on Rappler there, were very peaceful, and obviously this early proclamation helped. And this is absolutely refreshing, especially going from 10 to 2010 elections in that state.
Good to hear. That's Natashya Gutierrez reporting live from Cavite. Natashya, let us know what you're coming back to. All right, now let's go to Makati, to the Team PNoy headquarters, where Grace Tamayo just spoke to Francis Jumbone and Marlowe House Space. What did they have to say?
So we had in a brief interview this afternoon here at the Team PNoy headquarters in Makati, Liberal Party Chairman Francis Drilon said Grace Poe standing in the polls was a threat on society. Drilon explained that Poe's current standing could be due to her presentation as the one who would carry on the programs of her father, the late Fernando Poe Jr., into the Senate. Drilon said he thinks that Poe got the 11 million votes of SPJ in the 2004 presidential election, plus more. He also said he expected Lord and Legata to talk to her in polls, and she was consistently number one in surveys. Drilon added that her in number six in the senatorial polls that Tony Angara exceeded his expectations, as he thought he was just ranked number nine or number 10. Meanwhile, Interior and Local Government Secretary Mila Rojas congratulated the nation, who he believes is the real winner in the current, in the recent midterm election. Rojas reveals he is happy with the current nine Liberal deaths included in the Magic 12, but said he would have been happier if it was 12-0. Ross also added that he is also happy with Grace Poe standing and advised her as a fellow top-notcher in the 2004 senatorial elections to just stay within herself, keep her head, and just do her work. Mamiya, we also asked Secretary Ross about his plan for the 2016 presidential election, but he just laughed and avoided the question. He instead reported reported about the decline of election-related incidents around the country in the recent national election. And that's the link up here in Makati at the Team PNoy headquarters. Maria?
Thanks so much, Abe. The two team men that you spoke with, the former vice candidate for president who stepped down, as for many of you know, and the really big time to put a Team PNoy's campaigns together, so they must be feeling good as well. All right, let's move on. The Mafia vice candidates. The sense the candidates. As part of the group, we said earlier, they wanted to prevent the race and finalizing the time for senators. I want to speak to the rapid test. But we're suspending it because when we do a simultaneously, the candidates which are for the vote is delayed because there seems to be many issues to send the candidates. Some of the various provinces in the country, two of the team PNoy gets in the midterm polls, combined these voters provinces. 16 million registered voters, a third of the country's 52 million. In a trend based on early studies, Team PNoy gets occupied 8 to 9 spots in Cavite, with us, Northern Cima, Laguna, Rizal, Andahuaylas, Batangas, and Valle del Sur. Some of its votes are living in Cebu and Negros Occidental. Cebu, after two registered voters, fails to deliver, for Una has only two votes. Vice President Josh Villanueva better than Grace Poe, and the San Francisco News Review group gives them such a twist. The congressional elections are held to lead in elections to prepare to approve the votes of proclamations, even if the Department of Response system has not received all results. Thank you, Sixto Brillantes. So, regional officers may disregard time-counted votes as long as these don't affect the standing of the candidates. Brillantes says Comelec made this decision after receiving requests from candidates who wanted proclamations as late as Monday night, including former president and new Manila Mayor Joseph Estrada, who was never occurring today. Commissioner on Elections Sixto Brillantes says the election results are published, but two of the observers remain unofficial. Brillantes is referring to the Comelec central server, to the transparency server that has mirrored in that particular server. He says the only official results that come from the server of the Municipal Board of Elections. The administration coalition is dominating the senatorial race, based on the unofficial results transmitted from half of the constituents in July. Based on 52.23% completed transmissions, the lucky winners include 9 candidates from Team PNoy and 3 from the opposition United Nationalist Alliance. This represents the vote of 27.33 million voters. Former Senator Chief Grace Poe still talks to the polls. As soon as the vote started to come in, and has stayed there for the last week, is now going into nearly 24 hours of the top of the hour. Her conscious name has changed since the last wave of votes transmitted shortly after the first post made their team. If this trend continues as it has through the last 24 hours, this will be the first senatorial election that re-elected Senator Lauren Legarda will not be winning the first place. The latest unofficial count gives Poe a 1.2 million lead over second person Lauren Legarda. Election Watchdog now persists with rumors of free election contracts passing through 2013 midterm polls, but generally peaceful in order. National members of the committee chairs and Michael Nagual said the number of ballot issues is relatively small compared to previous election years. In a press release Monday evening, National Chairperson came from the Paterno Esmaquel out. But we're happy to know the enthusiasm and patience of voters who brave the long queues and heat. That's one of the missing election official stations. So the president voted as part of the president in Washington, D.C. to appoint the new mayor of Manila just a few hours ago. Estrada wins over the electionist mayor of Federal and the liberal party. The Estrada and the Manila condom is one of the most heated rivalries in the country's midterm elections. Estrada started out as mayor of Manila in 1969. He became president in 1998. Later impeached in 2021 and convicted of perjury. Let's get back to look at the results that we've been getting. As you know, if you go to the front page of Rapper, you're going to see a list of accounts where you can go to get the latest results. Just go drop the email address. Tell us, where are you now?
We're still at the results of the 6th of June, the slowly trickling in. Our turnout is still at 54.36%. in the lead the very fifth that we also came in almost 24 hours ago is the Poe Grace Poe, who has 14,666. Surprised. Many people were surprised that she figured in is number one unit to the place, so five days on the survey. But actually, took a look, Maria, at the historical survey released across Asia from February 21st all the way to April 2013. And you take a look at in 2012 in February, the first time they included her in the survey, she was like 24 to 33. That climbed up a little bit higher. At the start of the year, January, she was 13 to 16. In February, 4 to 10. In March, 4 to 10. But in April, she was already 3 to 4 based on the Pulse Asia prediction. And so, as you can see, as from January to April, she climbed higher and higher. The last survey was at the end of April. So, it is not actually surprising for her to be in this top spot because that's what she did. Trajectory at which she was actually the popularity of Tata. Let me just go through the rest of the results in the lower the data is in second place of 13,424,000. So the IOC is typically about 12,693,000. CS Cudero Verde for 512,684,000. Number 4, Nancy Dina Aguina. 6, Sunny Andara. Baja Pino, 7. Coco Pimenta, 8. Sunny Sonatic, 9. Cinco de la Tech, Baby of Health for 11, and Spider Gringo for that time, Fortuna, of course.
And Josh Widowfoot now is Brian Gonzalez. You're hitting the campaign trail, you're going to show you the fun of this. Oh, Brian, welcome to that show. Very nice.
I think I just briefly put in the coverage of the campaign.
It's such a film season, what we call the theater. What was the computer like for
you? It was somewhere between the hell and the sea. I can't explain it. It's a lot of work. It is more than what the people in the film really defined it. And I ended up doing a lot of things. But still, I'm very rewarded. It is Japanese comfort, Prince Edward's Rivers.
We used to talk about how well
you know, the time to take me just going to be for the movies. I was most completely my regular advisor, the most effective method of sales, to come in with the and then I think it's that. So it's been out of one. All of us didn't want to be
how would you describe what type of things you learn about the community?
What lessons did I learn? One, the staff and teams is really important to have. That's the only thing we can do. We can do things that are going to be able to do with staff and staff or then you're going to have a hard time. I remember when we started out something. Your main level of monetizing all this, and you have the potential to bring up people who are really interested in radio interviews, attending the debates, going on TV as much as possible. And most of those people who are interested in that, the individuals. And how does it set forth? And, you know, even put up your platform. That's what this can be like. Because when people find out who you are, then they look for what you mean about. And I think my mom knows that because they have seen my personal information today. She went on to do some questions and look at the videos. Just so people know what she's like before. And how she's like,
I watched the mock post and just attended the last interview, which was the really nerve-wracking interview because, when she found out that she was the mood leader that was going to be research in the group, I watched it. It's not a thing. She was thinking about it. It was like, and then she went and went to the side, told us about it, and I was on stage and did it. I was like, I did it. I was trying to describe her now. What kind of woman is she? She's quite a lot of outside of the citizen
system. To be honest, we're a very low team. And we don't really, even though we're at home, we're not sure if we can go up with the news that on Tuesday, that brings up for a long time, most people have to this. This is not really the part of my mom to kind of do it. To be honest, because before this, maybe like 30 days, I'm not too correct. Of course, you know, she's most comfortable in the interview, and you know,
2.5 points. What was the lowest point of that I'm going to be
why do you need this fund?
Grace Poe, Thank you.